thank you for tracking down that spot. Quite the view you captured. Very nice. I'd say you're a first-rate photographer now. If the association had any lingering doubts about you, this latest shot should have completely dispelled. At this rate, you'll outrank me. But hey, friendly competition never hurt anyone.
Begun to fulfill your potential. Long have I awaited this day. At ease, young soldier. I took your measure the moment you set foot in this town. Hard not to, given your presence. I am Navalon of the Thousand Eyes. Years of meditation have granted me sight beyond sight. It is this clarity which shows me all. Even that which some wish to keep hidden. You exude a powerful, yet troubled aura. Indeed, it makes you the perfect opponent. Come, and don't you dare hold anything back.
my name is Ludrell Balmont, and I am the creator of the game Queen's Blood. Which means that this nightmare is of my own making. I didn't know. How could I? You hear her too? Time's running out. She's calling me. Commanding me. She's made me her prisoner. Her cursed guard, my shackle. The end is nigh. Or perhaps this is only the beginning. The Shadow Blood Queen is...
Ah, let me guess. You have dreamt the dream of Ludrell Balmont too.
What do you know about it?
Only rumors and hearsay that players of particular skill have experienced strange visions of late. Visions in which one is visited by the ghost of the game's creator, who speaks of portentous events. To add another wrinkle, some of the world's very best have recently met with unnaturally violent deaths. People are calling this the Curse of Ludrell. Not even my third eye can discern the true cause, though it is clearly something sinister. If you wish to continue on the path of the cards, then remain vigilant. It may lead to your undoing.
You talk to this old fella instead. He's tough. Tougher than he looks. And real good at solving people's problems, right? You charging kids now?
You can pick up their tab. Well, what's the problem?
You see, Mr. Birdie ran away and hasn't come back.
Oh, Mr. Birdie is a bird friend of ours? His head is all pointy. Kinda like yours, mister.
Pointy, huh? I bet they're talking about Cloud Jr.
Who's that?
Your bird friend. He had a run-in with a nasty fiend, and we saved his tiny behind.
No way!
You guys, Grandpa said he saw Mr. Birdie heading toward the desert.
What? But we aren't allowed to go all the way out there.
You just leave it to us. We'll find your friend.
Really?
Promise.
Great. Grandpa said there's some old birdhouses out in the desert that people built back in the Republic days. He said those are good places to set traps.
Oh, and my mommy told me you can craft them yourself if you've got the right chip.
In that case, we'd better figure out how to transmute us some traps.
Grandpa said in the old days, they used to trap birds.
What? But why would they hunt their friends?
They didn't hunt them, just caught them for fun and stuff. But Grandpa said you can't find traps like that anywhere anymore.
So we just gotta make new ones instead.
I hope Cloud Jr.'s okay out there.
bet you'll just yoink the crown right off the king's head. Can't wait to see it in person. Just don't keep me waiting too long. We Johnnies are delicate flowers that wilt in the desert heat.
Deal with that. My turn.
Come on!
It's on you.
Leave it to me!
This one's a showstopper!
This one's for you!
Hey, that ought to work for our Cloud Junior catching purposes, right?
Wait.
Might as well rig the other traps then. Life was a hell of a lot simpler back in old Midgard. We were good, Shinra was bad, and if we took him out, the world would be all right.
So, it's changed.
Not a damn thing. Shinra's still going down, but coming back here, I see how I got tunnel vision. And not because Shinra was all I had to think about. 'Cause I didn't want to think about anything else. Saving the planet's important, but I put a lot of personal stuff on the back burner, and I shouldn't have. Dying and the others helped give me that clarity. Just wish I could have got it sooner. You'll find this hard to believe, but I've actually changed quite a bit since my younger days. Thanks to Tifa. But mostly, she really set me straight, especially as a man. Wouldn't be half the father I am today without her.
That's so. What'd she do?
Oh, got fed up with my bullshit and taught me a new one. Started yelling about how a kid like Marlene needed a proper roof over her head. Somewhere safe and clean. Said sleeping outside was risky.
She was right.
Sure was. And not just her. The whole team helped me get my act together. I used to be a runaway train, charging full speed ahead and dragging folks along for the ride. Never thought about hitting the brakes or anything else. Had my fair share of crashes and went off the rails a few times. Caused a lot of trouble for those guys.
Well, I'd say you managed to get yourself back on track.
I couldn't have done it without them. They came into my life for a reason. Like you did, huh? Junior.
as you get your hold.
Analysis of the Corel Summon Crystals. I can't tell you how grateful I am for everything you've helped me learn about Alexander. Thank you. Ah, though you have yet to obtain the requisite materia, as I recall, you'll first need to confront the Divine via the combat simulator. Of your royal quarry, the Tonberry King. Johnny wasn't that far off. Let's not keep your entrepreneurial friend waiting, lest he wither in the heat.
Thank you.
for those craggy cactuars.
Gloves up.
Rare landworm variant identified. Commencing guidance protocol. Their eyes have smart. These creatures rely on their senses to smell. Their digestion has forcing them to ingest rocks to break down food and absorb nutrients.
Assignments in the Corel region.
What assignments they were! You faced so many fiends! Sholopods, spearhawks, landworms, chimeras.
That's quite enough. Anyway, I've added a new combat trial to the simulator, Cloud. Do check it out sometime.
Thank you.
crown belongs in a far statelier head than his, namely yours. I say it's high time we divest him of it.
Now!
biometrics, we can better understand Tonberry's social structures. Our research proceeds apace. Thank you, Cloud.
Ouch. Looks like Cloud got a little scuffed in the scuffle. What do you think? Should we give it to Johnny anyway? See if he even notices? Or should we try for a nicer one instead?
Let's go and check another.
Thank you.
Let's check the other.
Junior, thought you were gonna wind up Monster Child. Oh, is that your way of saying you're good on your own? But go straight home, you hear me?
Wouldn't recommend going out there, unless you got a death wish.
Hey, mister, he's back! Clem Jr. came back!
Of course he did. When we found him, we said, your friends are looking for you. You head straight home.
No wonder! Thank you so much.
Hey. Just doing a job.
Go on, eat up.
Someday you're gonna be big and strong and scare away all the monsters.
Hope I can bring Marlene back here one day. Tell her about her home and everything else.
You sure that's a good idea?
I owe it to her father.
You'll feel better, maybe, but how do you think she'll feel? I don't know, man.
My dad says we're supposed to stay away from you. Sorry.
That's so. Well, don't want to get you in trouble. Us old fellas gotta go. Take care of Cloud Jr.
Thanks again for all your help, mister!
Don't mention it.
Ladies first.
Oh no, you're way better at the whole putting yourself in harm's way thing.
Fine.
Are you kidding me? Why? Me?
Word of advice? Don't fight it.
Yes, heed the voice of experience.
Let's head back to the reactor.
Thank you.
sure took you long enough. What do you say? Want to jump right into your second trial?
You know how this ends.
Do I ever? But to you?
Holy crap!
Let's see. Who looks fit to fight?
Ooh, me! Can I give it a go?
Fine by me. If the little lady wants to show off, I say let her.
Ha ha.
You're always welcome.
Thank you.